The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "What is your opinion? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them goes astray, will he not leave the 99 in the hills and go in search of the stray? And if he finds it, amen, I say to you, he rejoices more over it than over the 99 that did not stray. In just the same way, it is not the will of your heavenly Father that one of these little ones be lost." The Gospel of the Lord. So we as a church, we celebrate today St. Ambrose. St. Ambrose, who is a doctor of the church. St. Ambrose, who is also responsible for baptizing two additional great saints, St. Augustine and St. Jerome. And so I think it's pretty remarkable to see how St. Ambrose had this impact on these two other really great saints that we can see in history. St. Jerome, who would go on to translate and give us the Latin Vulgate, sacred scripture translated into Latin, and then St. Augustine, and we are very familiar with Augustine and his work, The Confessions. So our first reading today is from the prophet Isaiah. And one of the things, this is a lengthy reading, but it's such a beautiful reading because it's really summing up this summation of what we're in the midst of here in this season of Advent, this season in which we are looking both ways to eventually in the season of Advent to the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, but also to that time in the season of Advent when we will experience and we will encounter our Lord as a judge. And so one of the parts that really stood out to me this morning was, "All of the flowers shall wither, but the word of God remains." You know, it's something that's so strong. And I think for us as Catholics, we have to remember, you know, we have to sit with, we have to pray with, we have to dwell upon the Word of God. There's power in the Word of God. Flipping over into our gospel today, which comes to us from Matthew, one of my favorite parables. And when we look at the parables of Jesus, one of the things is that we try to think not in human terms with the parables. Because if we think in human terms with the parables, logically, would that shepherd leave his flock for that one sheep? It would be absolutely crazy for that shepherd to leave for that one sheep. But you see, thank all praise be to God that God is God. Because he is so willing to search for and go after that lost sheep. How many of us in our lives have been that lost sheep? How many of us can look back and say there were moments of grace in our lives where the Lord was calling us when we were so far away? How many of us right now, brothers and sisters, are that lost sheep? The Lord is calling each and every one of us back to his fold. And so this morning, I offer an invitation. If you've been away from the church, if you are not practicing your faith, maybe this Advent season is that time for you to return home. And so this morning, as we prepare to receive our Lord Jesus Christ in the Eucharist, we pray. Lord God, we thank you so much for allowing us to be here this morning to receive you, your body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Eucharist. Lord, we thank you for constantly seeking us out, for constantly calling us and giving us this invitation to grow deeper in love with you, to grow in faith, to grow in love, to grow in charity. Lord, we ask that as we receive you this morning, that we may truly continue to grow closer to you. Lord, may this Advent season be a season for us of growth. May it be a season for us to truly connect ourselves with you in a way that we have never thought possible. Jesus, we ask all of this morning and your most holy and sacred name. Amen.